Hello and welcome. My name is Russ Maxwell, and this is part three of the Hands-On Lab series. In Hands-On Lab 1, we built an Azure function that called Azure Key Vault and SQL in order to retrieve results and render them in the browser. In Lab 2, we integrated Application Insights and enabled custom logging within our Azure function. Although it's not a requirement, I recommend doing both labs and come back to this one. For those that watched the video, after coding that Azure function, we deployed it directly within VS Code via the Azure Resource Extension. In this lab, we'll deploy our Azure function in a more professional manner. We'll set up an Azure DevOps CI/CD pipeline to facilitate this work. If you don't have access to an Azure subscription or Azure DevOps, you should be able to gain enough insight by watching this video. Please like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll continue this series and venture into other technical areas of interest. So for everyone who has a refresh, or if you haven't watched the other videos yet as part of this lab series, I do want to show you this is what the result is of running that Azure function. And the reason why I'm showing you this is because, so currently my source is my local workstation, right? Because I deployed it from VS Code. And so what I expect is after this lab, my source is going to be changed. I'll be deploying from Azure DevOps via the CI/CD pipeline, and this should be the result. Okay, so that's the end of my intro. Let's dive into this. In step one, we need to prepare the infrastructure. So what I first need to do is I want to reuse the function app. And right now it has an Azure function deployed, so I need to delete it or get rid of it. So let me show you. If I go to the Azure extension, and I have the Azure function here, I'll let it refresh. If you don't see this, you'll need to sign in. But after you sign in to your own Azure subscription, you should see this. But I'll try to delete it. See what happens. Yes. Okay, it's deleted. So let's go verify in Azure portal that it's gone. So I'm going to come in here and verifying in Azure portal. Wait a minute, it's not deleted. Let me restart. Okay, it's restarted. Let me refresh again. It's still there. Let's go check VS Code again. Coming back into VS Code, you can see the function's back, right? So this never actually deleted. What if I try to delete the Azure function within Azure Portal? I can't. It's grayed out. Why does this happen? Microsoft removed the ability to disable or delete a Python-based V2 Azure function. I could start over and delete and recreate a new function app, but I'm stubborn and I don't want to do that. After some digging, I figured out you simply need to remove the function from your code and redeploy. Coming back to my code, I don't want to delete this code because I plan to use it again. And so a quick workaround for that is to simply comment out the function, redeploy, and that should remove the Azure function. And then when I'm ready to work with this code again, I uncomment. So let me run through that real quick. A good shortcut here is to hit, if you're on a PC, Control Shift End, or if you're on a Mac, hit the Shift and down arrow, and that'll select the current line and everything underneath. So let me do that now. We're good. And now I need to add my comments. And to do that, there's a couple ways to do it. I prefer the keyboard shortcut, and that is the Control and the /key on a PC, or Command and the /key on a Mac. And so I'm going to do that, and you can see everything is now commented out. Perfect. I'm ready to go ahead and deploy this, and let's verify the Azure function is gone. So I'll save this. Okay, coming back to my Azure extension, I'm going to select the function app, and I will deploy. All right, it's finished. Now the moment of truth, right? I'm going to go to the portal, refresh, and should be gone. And it's gone. So it's a good trick. It took me a little while to dig down and understand what's going on, but this is the way to work around this behavior. All right, great. The last part of this step is getting your deployment slot set up. Slots provide an added advantage of first deploying your solution into a staging slot. Staging provides a safe place to have a predefined set of users test and provide feedback after testing. Assuming feedback is positive and a decision is made to deploy to production, It's a matter of simply swapping the slot with the production slot. While I'm currently lacking an Azure function deployed, let's create a staging slot and inspect it for now. So I'm already in the deployment slot section. I'm going to click add. We'll call it staging. All right, it's created. So if I click on this, notice it takes me to the function app, but it appends the staging here, as well as it updates the URL. So when I decide to test this after deploying with my CI/CD pipeline, I'm going to hit this URL to test. Great. One more detail, it's not as obvious, is if I need to delete. So if, first off, let's go to deployment slots. You can see I've got my production and staging. Now in my staging overview page, one thing that's not as obvious is if I needed to delete this staging slot, I would come up here and click delete. Type in the name and hit delete, and that'll remove the slot. Just a heads up on that one, I'm not gonna do that here. I almost forgot one really important step with the staging slot. If I scroll down to identity, notice it's turned off. And if you recall the solution, it requires a managed identity in order to access Azure Key Vault and retrieve secrets. My production slot has the managed identity set up. So you would assume that the staging slot would leverage that managed identity. It does not. So if you're testing from the staging slot, the Azure function, it will fail unless you have a managed identity present. So I'm going to turn that on. Let's save it. Okay, looks like it has a managed identity. Let's go check out the Entra ID and make sure we see it. And click Enterprise Applications, select application type, pull down, and manage identities. I'll sort by created on, and you can see the managed identity is present. So now I have two of them for that Azure function. Great. Next step is, of course, I need to ACL this new identity onto my Azure Key Vault so that the staging slot will be able to go retrieve those secrets. So let's go get to the Azure Key Vault. Okay, access control, add role assignment. We were using Key Vault secrets user. Next, manage identity, select members. So what type, it's the managed identity is in a function app. Selecting my staging, it should pop down here under selected members, select, and review and assign. Okay, now we're set. So step complete, let's continue. Okay, in step two, we're gonna push our code up to the Azure repo. Let's go ahead and take a look. And this is my demo project. This is a project that I'll use to not only hold the repo, but also set up the CI/CD pipeline. When you create a project in Azure DevOps, it automatically has a repo ready to go. So this is the repo I'm gonna use. And currently nothing exists in it yet. That's going to change. I'm going to push an existing repo from command line. So I'll be using these commands. So I will initialize a Git repo from my local machine, and I'll add this solution to it, finally pushing those changes up to this repo. I assume most of the viewers here have some basic knowledge of using Git and repos, but to refresh everyone, the main idea behind the approach is referred to as distributed version control, and it allows multiple developers to work on the same code at the same time on their local machines. Once they're ready, they'll commit and push their changes to the repo. The repo, again, is just a storage location for your solution. So this also dives into a bunch of other topics like branching, pull request, approvals, and I'm not gonna cover those here. I'll include some links in the description though if you'd like to learn more about that. Okay, let's hop over to VS Code and set up our local Git repo. All right, back in VS Code. First thing I'm gonna need to verify is that I have Git installed, which I do, but if you don't, you can download it from git4windows.org. I'm gonna use a terminal to do this, although I don't have to. VS Code has some decent integration via the source control. So how do I ensure I'm having empty, that I haven't initialized any kind of a local Git repo? easiest way is to click on source control here, and you should see something like this, where it states it doesn't have a Git repo yet. I can initialize from here, but instead, again, I'm going to use the terminal. So to start, I will do git init. Okay. That initializes the repo. Now, before I add these files to the local repo, I need to uncomment, right? So control shift end to select everything, and control/. All right. That looks better. I'm going to save this, and now I need to add this to what's called staging. So git add dash a, and that looks good. Also, I can do git status to verify. It shows you all the new files that are in staging or changed files. Then to commit this into the main branch locally, I can do git commit dash m first commit. Now I need to add a link to the remote repo, and to do that, I just run git remote add origin, and then specify that URL. And again, this is that command that was available from the repo. All right, that's added. And now to confirm my origin looks good, I can do git remote v. You're going to see origin a lot. The word is used a lot in Git, and it's a default name given to a remote repository. Now that the remote origin is added, finally we can push the changes up. So I'm going to do git push / u origin all. Great, it's finished. When you first run the git push, there is a chance that you will be prompted for credentials via the Git credential manager. So after entering your credentials, you should be okay. But let's go check the repo. So I'm going to refresh this. And good, I've got files. This is exactly what I need. Okay, let's go set up our CI/CD pipeline. The CI stands for Continuous Integration, also referred to as the build pipeline. And that's where your code is compiled or packaged and presented for handoff to the release pipeline. The CD portion of that is called continuous deployment, and that's also referred to as your release pipeline. And that's where the package solution is processed and then deployed out to a service like an Azure service, like an Azure Function app. We want the pipeline to run to install dependencies required by the Python Azure function we authored in the previous labs. We want it to package that into a zip file, which is the format the function app expects to receive it in. So let's do that now. Let's click on pipelines and create pipeline. Okay, we're gonna select Azure Repos Git, and it is our demo project. Under the configure tab, go ahead and select Python package. Okay, and here's what the default pipeline looks like. We're not gonna use that. I'm gonna use one that I've already authored, and I will include this particular YAML file that I'm pasting in the lab3 folder on my GitHub repo, and I'll include a link to that in the description. Okay, let's see if I can get through this in 60 seconds and describe this YAML pipeline. First, the trigger. This signals when changes are made to the repo's main branch, this build pipeline will kick off automatically. The pull instructs Azure DevOps where to package or compile the code. And it uses VMs that are spun up, the code is copied, and then built. Next, I have one step that contains multiple tasks. You could have multiple steps, each containing a task, or one step that contains all your tasks. A few reasons why you might consider breaking up your task into multiple steps are reusability or more detailed error logging, to name a few. The first task on line 13 specifies the runtime I need to use, which is Python 3.9. The second task on line 18 is super important. This installs your dependencies, and the target is specified to instruct where the dependencies should be stored on the file system. If you don't specify a target and run pip install and point to requirements.txt, the modules won't be published as part of the zip file or artifact. The result of the zip package without dependencies means that when the solution is deployed in the release pipeline, the Azure function won't appear in the Azure Function app. Finally, I have the archive files and the publish build artifact task. And archive files task, this is responsible for packaging the content into a zip file, while the publish build artifacts is responsible for publishing the zip as an artifact, which makes it available to the release stage. So let's go ahead and save it and run it. You can put whatever commit message you want. And notice commit directly to the main branch, save and run. So it's queued right now. Let's let this run. And you can see the dependencies are downloading. I think it's complete. Excellent, it's done. Let's verify this looks good. I know this looks good, right? Because here's my artifact. I've got one published. And if I expand this drop folder, there's my zip file. It's about 8 meg, which is what I expect because of the dependencies that are also included in this. So let's open this up and validate that the dependencies are present. Okay, bringing this over. And you can see I've got the Python packages here. I've got the library, the site packages, and all my modules are listed. So good news, let's move forward. Okay, next up, let's set up the release pipeline. This is the CD portion. Let's click on releases, new pipeline. Here I need to select a template. I'm gonna search for a function. I'm gonna select deploy a function app to an Azure function. This is worded a little odd to me for some reason, but just know that this is going to deploy your Azure function to your function app. I'll just leave it as stage name one. Next to artifacts, I need to add my artifact, which was published. Just click add here. Where's the build pipeline? It's right here. And I'm gonna click add. Next, I'll click on the job task link, select my Azure subscription. If you see a message in red underneath, that essentially means you need to connect, and I'm gonna click authorize to do so. And what's happening is this is setting up an app registration with an Entra ID, and it gives Azure DevOps an identity. In other words, it's a service principal, and it's assigned and granted permissions to the Azure resources defined by this release pipeline. App type. It's gonna be a function app on Linux, it's running Python, and what's the app name? And it's LabAZFunk. Okay, let's save that. Let's finish this up and click the deploy Azure function app task. And first off, the task version. If you're running V2 functions like I am, you should be selecting version 2 because it leverages the new zip deploy feature. All right, scrolling down a little further, I'm also deploying to a slot. So we need to point to that staging slot. I'll select the resource group, and I am deploying to the staging slot. Good. Next is the runtime stack. Our function's running on Python 3.9. So select that. And then finally, there's some additional options in here I'm not gonna cover, but feel free to look these up and do a good review of those if you're interested in using any of them. Let's go ahead and save. Let's click the pipeline tab next. The last thing we want to do is enable continuous deployment. This ensures that whenever the build pipeline completes and updates a new artifact or new build, this release will automatically run and push those changes to my staging slot. So let's click on that and continuous deployment trigger. Just select enabled and save it. That should be good. You should see a little check mark underneath the lightning bolt. We're all set. Let's test this new release pipeline out by creating a release. So up at the top, I'm gonna click releases, select create a release. And then for this field, I'm going to select stage one. So I'm gonna select this artifact here and add a description, hit create. Let's click on release one. Notice it's not deployed, click deploy. I'll find myself hitting refresh quite a bit during this process, and it should update where things stand currently. So you can see it's fetching the artifact, and now it's deploying the Azure function. Okay, all set. Let's go test this out. All right, back in the Azure portal, I'm in my LabAZ function app, and notice there's no function. Well, remember I deployed to the staging slot, so there shouldn't be a function in the production slot yet. And just to validate that, let me hop in here, and I'm passing that name parameter equals magic, and notice I get that error. So let's come back, let's go ahead and review the staging slot to see if that Azure function actually deployed. So under deployment slots, I'll click staging. Fantastic, we have success. Let's grab the URL endpoint of this, and within code and test, just get function URL. So for me, any one of these works, just copy it. Let's see, the function name is gonna be the same as well as the API. So let's just replace this part. Okay, and then we'll clean up whatever's left over. So name, there, that looks good. Good news, this was successful. Now that we've validated and verified it looks good, let's swap this with our production slot. So I'm gonna come back to deployment slots, click swap. Source staging, target is the regular LabAZ func, and I'm gonna hit start swap. Excellent, it's complete. Let's take a look. Let's see where I'm at. I'm in the production slot right now. Notice the Azure function is now present. Good news. Let's test this out. So instead of, we're just gonna remove this hyphen staging. And we're good. So excellent, we've come full circle. Let's recap. In step one, we cleaned out the Azure function from the function app and created a staging slot. In step two, we pushed our local Git repo into a repo sitting on Azure DevOps. In step three, we created a build and release pipeline, ultimately deploying the Azure function to staging. And finally, in step four, we validated the Azure function success in staging and swapped to the production slot where we now have success. Most of these tasks were manual, and now that we have our CI/CD pipeline with continuous deployment set up in Azure DevOps, let's run through the final step of making a minor change in our Azure function and ensuring once we push that change up to the repo that it makes it to its final destination, which is the staging slot. Okay, back in my Azure function, I'm gonna make a simple change. So if I go down to my parameter, you know, I was listening for magic, I'm gonna change that. And we're gonna change it to Jordan is the GOAT. Sorry, LeBron fans, I'm old school. And that's it, that's all I'm gonna do. I'm gonna save that. Git add A, we're gonna add that to staging, git commit, and we'll call it Jordan. And then finally we're gonna git push, and that's just gonna push this change up to the repo. It should kick off the build pipeline. Notice I have this error, and the most probable scenario in my case is I've updated the build pipeline and that updated YAML file, that change is not propagated down. So I need to do the git pull to retrieve that latest version, and then I should be fine. Okay, I should be able to do my git push and now it should work. All right, let's go check out the pipeline. Let's click on pipelines, and it's running currently. Fantastic. Moving quick. Finished. That was super fast, fantastic. Let's check the releases out. There it is. There's our release 2. Let's take a look. And we can monitor it from here. Okay, it's completed. Let's validate. So it's currently in the staging slot, right? So I need to select that particular URL. I think it's staging, if I'm not mistaken. And remember, the name is no longer Magic. It is Jordan is the Goat. And it worked. We are in business. I hope that was helpful. And if you would like to see more videos, please comment and let me know what you'd like to see. And I'm probably going to dive into more advanced Azure DevOps topics moving forward. But in any event, you made it to the end. Congratulations and thank you for watching.